is the answer to our tricky word quiz. Let's go through these answers one by one. First, every infection can be traced back to a defect that causes it. This is actually correct, because if we have an infection, if we have an error in the program state, that is, we can find out which defect causes it, namely the piece in the program which got a sane state as input and which produced an erroneous state, an infection, as output. Second, every execution of a defect causes an infection. That's actually not the case. It may well be that there's a defect in the code which operates only under certain circumstances, which works fine most of the time, and only under certain circumstances produces an infection. So this is not correct. Every infection ends in a failure. If only it were so, then it would be far easier to make our programs defect-free. No, like real infections, they can die out before they ever cause real harm. Finally, every defect can cause a failure. Ha, that's tricky. Remember, a defect is an error in the code. A failure is an error in the execution, an infection an error in the state. A defect is an error in the code. And you can have an error in the code, even in code that's never executed, or in code that's actually unreachable. How can it be an error if it can never be executed? Well, it may well be that over time, when the program is maintained, the error actually becomes executable, then it can actually cause a failure. It is not the case that every defect always can cause a failure, because defects may be in unreachable code, and therefore they may not cause a failure. So this is not correct just as well.